Happy New Year, everybody! So glad to see y'all. All right, let's start out this morning just do a little bit of warm up our ankles and our arms. Lift up and bow. Lift up your right knee and just rotate your foot and your hands. And go the other way. All right, let's come back to the down. Roll those shoulders back and down. Arms out. Let's do the other leg. Left leg. Rotating that ankle and your hands. Go the other way. All right, roll those shoulders back. We're going to march. Let me let...
This is Debbie. Let me let her in.
All right. March right left. Good morning, Debbie. We're glad to have you. Now take a big deep breath in. And exhale. Give me another one. Now roll your shoulders back. And roll your shoulders forward. March it out wide. All right, let's plant those feet. Bring your hands above your knees. Flatten your back. Round it up. Touch your chin to your chest. Hold it. Flat neutral, round it up, and last time, flatten that back out, round it up slow and easy. All right, we're going to go to heel digs. Here we go. We'll wipe your curls with this. Debbie, just whatever we're doing, try to do it in the chair. I'll give you some instructions. All right, we're going to go to inner thighs. Here we go. Reach out, touch that instep. Use your ab muscles and knees to the front. Push it up. Now low kick front. Easy on those knees. Control your kicks. Abductors. Lift those legs straight out to the side. Knees side. Lift them up high. Those hips warmed up. Hamstring curls. Pull those arms back. Squeeze in the shoulder blades. March it out. All right, we're going to take our feet out a little bit wide, and we're going to go down and squat. Pulse for three. All right, so Debbie, if you can lift yourself out of your chair just a little bit with one leg. Let's do that. Here we go. So go down for three, two, one. Bring it up. Three, two, one. Keeping those knees behind your toes. Keep going. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Last one. Three, two, one. And stand up. Shake it all out. Lift those knees. Let me let
Marianne come on in.
All right. Okay, so we're going to go into a right knee step. And Debbie, just in your chair. And I can just sit here. You can go out, and in like this. If you can do that. All right, marching it out. Get ready for that right knee. Here we go. Legs out wide and bring them back together. Use those arms. Start to bring that heart rate up. Now switch your legs, left leg. Four more. Four, three, two, and one. March it out. Okay, we take those legs out wide. Knees and toes are pointed out. We're gonna lunge it right and left. Here we go. Punch it out. Now hold it on the right. You can stretch the left inner thigh muscles. And then switch. All right, bring it back to center. Now we just want you to swing your hips forward and back. Forward, back, forward. Just warming up those hip flexors a little bit. Four, three, two, and one. Walk it on in. All right, we're going to go to some heel digs again. Actually, just take the right heel to the floor. Support yourself over part of the left thigh. Push your hips back, lean up, like hold the toes back. Feel this to the back of that right leg. And bring up the flat to the floor and squat it down. Push that heel into the floor. Tap your foot. Tap, get it out, get out, get out. And hold your toes in. And bring up straight and then switch those legs. Left heel to the floor, push your hips back, lean your leg, pull the toes back before you. Foot flat to the floor, squatting down. Dig that heel into the floor, point your toes. Tap your foot. Tap in and out. Marianne, we're glad you could join us this morning. All right, take that, those toes in. Bring it back straight. Step back. Roll it on under the back and through the neck. All right, let's get a sip of water, and then we're going to do some cardio, and then we'll get into bar and all of that. All right, so Debbie, just try to do the things with the legs, whatever you can do with the legs, sitting in the chair, and arms. Just, that's going to bring your heart rate up regardless. All right, so we're going to start out this morning with tire runs. So, Debbie, you'll just be right here. All right, get ready to go. Right foot, let's go. So you can be up on the balls of your feet, or you can go faster. Put that 45-second time clock on. And walk it out. All right, march it out. All right, we're going to go to a TikTok or a pendulum, so we're going to swing those legs side to side. So, Debbie, if you can, sitting at you, just lift those legs slightly out to the side and just do some more. All right, get ready to go. TikTok. So, you can be right here, or you can add that power. Keep your knees soft, abs tight. Sort of like that. All right, we're rest of you, it's mambo, cha-cha-cha, mambo, cha-cha-cha. All right, get ready to go. And here we go. Mambo, cha-cha-cha. Once you get those legs, add some arms. Bring them up high for more cardio. I got a 15 seconds left on this one. This is a nice, easy one. Well, we can get that cardio, that heart rate up with those arms. And march it up. Woo! Okay. We're going to go into some lunges. So it's going to be lunging side to side. It can be right here, or it can be power, and it can be arms up. Both arms up for more. Let's go. This is low. This is higher. You choose your level, listen to your body, but challenge yourself. Through the mouth. take your arms out to the side, and then slightly shift your weight leg, left knee out to the side. Breathing in nice and deep. And relax it. All right, shake your legs out really good. Lift your knees. Now let's go to the other side. Hands together, elbows together. Pull those elbows down. Now lift your left knee up to the front. Find that focal point focus. Super important for us to practice our balance. Use it or lose it. All right, we're going to slowly take those arms out to the side and shift that knee out to the side. Very difficult to shift your weight and keep your balance, so we want to practice that. Keep holding it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, shake those legs out really good. Lift the knee. Okay, we're going to pull our chair in. Debbie's already got hers. Yay. All right, I'm going to turn it around this way. Okay. So I'm going to show you these to begin with in the chair. And then if you want to stand up and do it, you can. So we're going to start out with just lifting the knees like this. And you want to have your body straight up and down. Roll the shoulders back and down. Keep your core really tight. We'll lift the knees, and then we're going to do leg extensions. All right, let's do both legs. Let's see if there's anything else I'm going to show you for while I'm right here. Oh, we'll also do some circles and some point and flex, which is really good for your ankles, Debbie. And all of us, because we want to keep those ankles strong. All right, so if you want to stand up and do this, it's fine, but you're welcome to sit in your chair if you'd rather. All right, shoulders back and down. Lift that right knee. Here we go. Lift it, release it. Lift it, release it. Keep that left knee slightly bent. You don't want to lock the knee out. Nice deep breathing. Seven. Six. Five. Four. One, now lift up, hold it for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm going to give you a quick little break to kind of shake it out, because this is, we might not make it if we didn't, okay? Lift that knee, now leg extension, same leg. So you want to lift that, your knee should be level with your hip, and you want to try to straighten that leg almost all the way out. Give me 8 more. Yeah. Are you feeling it? Yes, I hope so. I am. Right through that quad, those quadricep muscles. 4, 3, 2, 1. Extend, hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Ah, shake those legs out, lift the knee. All right, put that right foot right underneath your hip. Roll those shoulders back and down, arm out to the side. Tuck in those ab muscles. Lift that left leg. Now lift it straight up to the ceiling. Lift, release. Lift, release. Lift, release. Keep it coming. Eight to go. 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now lift up, hold it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, quick little recovery here. Shake those legs out. Lift your knees. All right, and we're ready to do those leg extensions. All right, put that right foot underneath your hip, shoulders back and down. Get ready. We're going to extend that leg straight out. Here we go. Out and in. Out and in. Out and in. Keep those abs tight. You're getting a good core workout here. Eight, seven, six, five, five, four, three, two, and one. Relax it. Oh my goodness, shake those legs out really good. Okay, I think we'll take a break before we do the leg rotations and everything, because that's working your quadriceps again and also your ankles. Let's see. All right, we're going to work on the outer thigh. Okay, so what I want you to do is hold on to your chair, or Debbie, you're just sitting here. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this leg out to the side and back in. This is, it's not easy even sitting in the chair. Okay. All right. Put all that weight into that left leg. Roll those shoulders back and down. Now I want you to bend that left knee so you're in a teeny tiny little squat, keeping that knee behind your toes. Make sure your body, your upper body is up, is lifted up. All right, we're going to take that leg straight out to the side. Here we go. Out, in. Out, in. It's like you're just sliding it on the floor. You know, if we were at the gym, we would be using those sliders where we slide it right along the floor. Give me eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Extend hold for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Relax it. All right, lift those knees. Shake it out really good. All right, we're going to take that chair over to the other side just so our foot doesn't run into the chair, the left leg. All right, we're holding it. Now, you want to soften up that right knee, actually sitting back into a tiny little squat. All right, body upright. Let's take that leg straight out. Out, in. Out, in. Out, and in. Shake your legs out really, really good. Okay. We are going to do one more. We're really working this quad this morning. All right, so we're going to take this leg out. Remember, you can be sitting in your chair, and we're going to rotate the foot. Here we go. Rotate in a circle. Go the other way. Again, ankle flexibility and strength. And relax. All right, shake those legs out really good. Lift your knees. All right, get that left foot right underneath your hip and lift that right leg out. Left leg. Excuse me. Sorry. All right, now rotation. Whichever leg you didn't do. So if you're with me, you're doing your left leg right now. And go the other way. And relax. All right, shake it all out. Lift your knees. Okay, now we've got a ton of stuff for our quadriceps, so I really want to work our hamstrings. So, this is really kind of functional. So I want you to put your chair here. And of course, if Debbie, if you're still sitting in your chair, you can just try to do this from your chair. Okay, so what we're going to do is I've got my left hand on my chair, right foot's right underneath my hip. Left foot's right underneath my hip, shoulders back and down. Now, what I want you to do is bend this right knee, and we're going to push it out like we're shutting a door. Here we go. Shut that door, bring it back. Shut that door, bring it back. Now, as you do that, feel that core working, even into the obliques, and you're working your hamstrings. So push that foot. We were loading up boxes. My daughter moved to Mount Pleasant on Saturday, and she's been ordering furniture online and all kinds of stuff. You should have seen the boxes. It just made me sick. All right, take it back. Push that foot. The boxes that they can send stuff in are just ridiculous. So anyway, we filled up my whole van and Lee's truck with boxes that took in the dump yesterday. All right, push, push. Push. Just little ones right here. We're not going as much. We're not going as far. This is smaller. Anyway, I was opening and closing those doors constantly with my foot. Now, thought about this exercise. It's functional. Oh, right into those hamstrings. Very small. And relax it. All right, shake your legs out really good. Lift the knees. You need these stretches in between for recovery. All right, put your right foot underneath your hip. We're going to bend this left leg, shoulders back and down. Nice, good posture. And we're going to push that foot out. Here we go. This is the one that's a little bit bigger. More motion here. And squeeze the glute muscles and squeeze the hamstrings as you do this. Last one of these. All right, now take that leg and push it out. Hold it. Now the little baby ones. Here we go. Push. Push. Really small, but more intense on this. Keeping that right the left knee slightly bent. I'm getting my right and left mixed up today. A little dyslexic. Last one. And relax. All right, shake those legs out really good. Lift your knees. And we're going to be done with this. So if you're not Debbie, you can put your chair away. Okay, grab the water. We're going to start out with one lightweight today. Charge for your weight, squat, pick it up. All right, grab your weight like so. We're going to do some halos. So feet are about hip width apart or something like that. And bring your weight up over your head, abs are as tight as you can make them. But we're going to go clockwise. All right, make those circles around your head. And the bigger it is, the more you're working. So as you go around behind your back, you're going to feel that into your back muscles. As you come front, you're going to feel it into your core, and then in the obliques on the sides. And then you're getting your arms, your shoulder, your rotator cuffs. So a good exercise. All right, we're going to go counterclockwise now. Go the other way. Nice and slow and controlled motion. Give me 8 more. And relax it. All right. Chin on your chest. Work your neck too. You can feel it. Okay. So we're going to squat down and grab that other light weight. All right. Once you take your legs out, so their knees and toes are pointing out to the side. Now come on down to a plie squat. Now the ideal here is to have your knees right over your ankles. That's the ideal. You most definitely do not want them like this with your knees going past your toes, okay? All right, now we're going to come down here. Your palms are towards the ceiling. Wrists are straight. And we're going to work it. We're going to take the palms to the floor to the ceiling. Here we go. To the floor, to the ceiling. Okay, Christmas Eve, my mom fell. I always talk about this. My mom fell and broke her wrist. And what I always think of when I do these is to strengthen your wrist so that that won't happen. My mom doesn't do any exercise, literally, except a little tiny bit of walking, mostly sitting on the couch watching TV. So, I want to have strong wrists. I don't want them to break. So, we're doing this to strengthen forearm, biceps, and wrists. Alright, now take your palms to the floor. Wrists are straight. Now a little lift right here. Lift up to the ceiling. We're working our biceps in a different way than we normally do. So good stuff. Alright, now flip it over. Palms to the ceiling and keep lifting. Wrists are straight. And now we're going to take those arms out to the side and pulse it. Keep your hands about level with your elbows. All right, now we're going to flip those hands over, wrists are straight, and lift them straight up to the ceiling. Alright, now we're going to take those weights and put them on our hips. And Debbie, while we're doing this, you can do some more arms if you can take it. You know, maybe some Allison ends, or you can do some long biceps. Alright, we're going to go down for two. Down, down, up, and up. Down, and down, and up, and up. As you come up, keep your knees just slightly bent. Don't lock them out. Now go down for three. Three, two, one, bring it up. Down, two, three, bring it up. Down, two, three, bring it up. Down, two, three. Now come on down, and we're going to go to upright rows. And Debbie, you can do this. Roll those shoulders back and down, and we're going to go up for two. Lift the elbows. Up, and down, and down, and up, and up, and down, and down. You bring those elbows up level with your shoulders. Still working those legs by keeping this squat position. Singles, take it up and down. Up, down. Up, down. Up. I'm going slow with the beat. Don't listen to the beat. Now hold it here. Now go side to side. knees behind your toes. All right, bring it back to the center to pull those knees in and out. Pull them in and out. So Debbie, sit in the chair. You can have your feet out just a little bit wide and then pull your knees towards each other to work the inner thighs. Give me eight more. Eight, seven. You're also feeling this in a weird spot in your glutes, like in the center. So not only working your inner thighs, but also getting a good spot in those glutes. Eight, four more. Four, three, two, and one. All right, walking in. Oh my, that's when you feel it, when you walk it in. All right, lift those knees. Shake it all out. All right, take your hands, just let them hang by your side, chin on your chest. Woo, okay. Roll it back and down. All right, let's see what's next. All right, we're gonna squat the knees down. Take just a very quick break from the weight, but we're still gonna be working those arms. Okay, what I want you to do is I want you to bend your knees just slightly so you're in a tiny little squat, but what you've done is engage your leg muscles, okay? Everything is tight. All right, bring those arms in front, little circles. Use your abs here, use your core. And go the other way. So working those rotator cuffs, you're not probably not feeling too much of anything right now, but you will by the end. Alright, now we're gonna pull those fists into the chest and extend those fingers out as you straighten your arms out. So work your fingers, pull it in fists, straighten it out. Straighten those fingers out. Keep your hands about level with your shoulders. Keep those abs nice and tight. All right, now we're going to take those arms out to the side of this and make those circles. Go the other way. Right here, just let those weights hang, chin on your chest. All right, now we're gonna do a little bit of tricep work. Bring those weights to your shoulders. If you would like to switch to the lighter weights, that'd be fine. So we're gonna chin with the hip and engage the lower back, and we're gonna extend back for two. We're gonna keep it at twos because it's nice and slow. And I'm actually gonna slow this music down. Oh, it is slowed down. It did it automatically. Awesome. All right, weights to your shoulders, chin with the hip. Knees behind your toes, back for two. Back, back, up, and up. Now remember, the upper part of your arm between your shoulder and your elbow is pretty stationary. Don't move it. Just move the lower part of the arm. Back, back, up, and up. And back, and back, and up, and up, and back, and back, and up, and up, and back, and back. We're going to do four more of these. Back. I know it's getting boring, isn't it? Sorry. Two more. Now, what I want you to do is take it back and hold it and turn your palms towards the back wall. Hold it right here. You're lifting your arms just a little bit, engaging those tricep muscles. Now, pulse it here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. You're also getting in the upper back here. And relax it. All right, let those weights hang tight on your chest. All right, we're going to just put these weights away. Squat, put them down. Shake your arms out really good. Actually, keep one light weight. Keep one. Okay. Shake it all out. We're going to do a little stretch, and then we're going to go down to the floor for abs. I want you to take your right palm out, gently pull the fingertips back. And Debbie, you can, if you're still up for it, I can show you some options for doing the weights, I mean the abs in the chair. Bring that arm up and gently pull the elbow back. Now these muscles are still tight for those triceps, so ease into that stretch. Gently pull it back, gradually. All right, switch those arms, and remember, it's a gradual pullback, gradually increasing. Now take your palms to the ceiling and gently pull the fingertips back. All right, now we're going to slide those hands halfway down your butt, slide back. Round it up, put your chin to your chest, hold it. Flat neutral. Round up. Now pull those elbows in toward the center of your body so you're trying to make your elbows meet in front. And then release it, flat neutral back. Round it up. All right, let's stretch back the hamstrings. Right heel to the left heel to the floor. Support yourself up from the left of the right thigh. Push your hands back, bring up your leg, pull the toes back, Gordy. Goodness gracious. So you should go into the back of that leg. We're going to get into his hamstrings. All right, bring your foot flat to the floor. I want you to push your hips back, lean over your leg, dig your heel into the floor, the right heel, the left heel. Point your left toes. All right, then release your left hand and press it towards the floor. Your right hand. Oh my gosh, y'all, I'm so messed up today. Anyway, you know what you're doing. All right, release it. Come on up. All right, switch your legs because I was telling you the wrong leg all along and talking about that. All right, put your heel to the floor. Push your hips back. Lean over the leg. Pull the toes back for you. Now bring your foot flat to the floor. Dig your heel into the floor. Push your hips back. Lean over that leg. Now release your hand, same hand as foot, and press it towards the floor. Get into this hamstring. All right, release it, come on up. Let's take that right leg behind your left. Reach your right arm above your head. Really stretch here through these obliques. Reach it up there. Bring it back center, and easy does it, come on down over your legs, down as low as it's comfortable for you. Then straighten out that right knee just a little bit more. And release it, come on up, roll those shoulders, take the left leg behind your right, reach your left arm above your head, big stretch towards the ceiling. And bring it back center. And easy does it, come on down over your legs. Come down as low as it's comfortable for you. And straighten out that left knee just a little bit more. All right, release it and come on up, all the way up. Grab a sip of water, get your mat in place. And we're gonna go down to the floor. And Debbie, or if anybody else wants to sit in their chair, I'm gonna show you how to do those abs. A weight is optional. You can have one weight if you like. All right, very quickly, let me just show you. So, if you're going to be in your chair, we're going to do some rowing. So, you can be sitting up in your chair and row forward and pull back. Row forward. I feel my core working right now. You can do that, okay? Then we're going to do some Russian twists. So, you can be here. And then we're going to be laying down on the floor and we'll be lifting those knees. So you can lift your knees like so. All right, and then we're going to do one where we pull the rope. So if you're here, you're going to reach forward, pull. And as you pull, really feel it in those obliques. Pull it to the side. Okay, so pull me. Okay, everybody else, get on the floor if you want to. I've got to turn my heat off. I don't know what's wrong with this thing. So much for that heat programming. It doesn't work. Okay. So we're going to start out with the rowing. So you've got your weight in your hand. If you want to use a weight, you don't have to. Now, you can come back just a little bit and row forward a little bit, or you can go way forward, pull way back. Your choice. Let's go, pull back. Pull back, row forward. You listen to your body. If your lower back hurts when you do this, make it less range of motion, make it smaller. Last one. All right, relax. All right, now feet are about hip width apart, and we're gonna do a little bit of Russian twist. Now, you can be sitting straight up and twisting, okay? Or you can lean back and twist, or you can lift your feet up. All right, let's go. Here we go. Twist, center, twist, center. Right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, and left. Now pulse it. 3, 2, 1, center, 3, 2, 1, just two more. 3, 2, 1, center, 3, 2, 1, and center. All right, put your weight down. Then take your arms and wrap them under underneath your legs. If you're sitting in your chair, you can do this. All right, squeeze in tight to this leg, stretching through your back. All right, now if you're down on the floor, we're going to come down as slowly as you can, control it all the way to the floor. Okay, hands behind your head, you come rolling back, shoulders up. Now we're going to lift the knees up. So we're starting with one leg, doesn't matter which. Pull it in. All right, switch those legs. Keep those abs nice and tight. All right, now, both legs. Now, for those of you sitting in the chair, you can either do both legs or you can just continue alternating. All right, we're going to lift those hips up and bring those feet down back to the floor.
If we were easy as fishing, you could be a musician. If you can make sounds now,
keep your chin off your chest like a fist. Needs to be a fist width.
Straighten that right knee out a little bit more.
Now bring your right ankle to the left knee. You can do this in the chair. Take your hand. Don't push on your knee, but push on your leg. Press it away from you so you feel the stretch of the hip. Now pull that left knee into your chest, keeping that figure four. Feel that in your glute muscles. Pulling it closer. Now put that left foot flat on the floor, right foot flat, you come pulling back. Left heel up to the ceiling, push that heel higher than your toes, gently pull the legs from your chest. And if you're in the chair, you're pushing the heel toward the wall. Now point your toes, hard point. Rotate your foot in a circle. Go the other way. And again, press that heel higher than your toes, pull the legs closer to your chest. And then straighten that left knee out a little bit more. Bring that left ankle below the right knee. Take your left hand, press that left leg away from you to feel the left hip. Now, keeping this in your foot position, pull that right knee into your chest. And then pull it closer. Alright, release it. Grab your hamstrings, roll up. Alright, so if you're in the chair, your feet on the floor, you can just put your soles of your feet together and press your knees out a little bit. So if you're on the floor, you know what to do. Press those knees to the floor. Alright, keep it here. Lean over one more. Alright, release that. In your chair, just keep your legs like this, or just put them here like this. Sit up nice and tall. Take a big deep breath in. And then as you exhale, just lean over your legs and hold them right there. And take those arms over your right knee. That crescendo gets a little loud. All right, over that right knee. Stretch that left arm out a little farther, get the obliques. Bring it back center. And then arms go over that left knee and press your right arm out a little farther. Get the right oblique. And bring it back center. Now sit up nice and tall. Put your hands down beside your hips. Drop your chin to your chest. Stretch the back of your neck. Now bring your right ear toward your right shoulder. Just let that right arm just sort of hang and press your left palm into the floor. Now bring your chin to your chest. Now the left ear to the left shoulder and press your right palm into the floor. And bring your chin to your chest. And take your right hand above that left knee and press your left shoulder back. Look down that shoulder. Right to my heart. And then switch it up, left hand above the right knee, push your right shoulder back, look down that shoulder. You can light up the dark. And bring it back center. Let's interlace your fingers, stretch your arms out front around your back. And then put the hands on the lower part of your back and squeeze your shoulder blades together, open up the chest. And let's step forward. We're going to come into a crouch position. Palms on the floor. Roll back onto the balls of your feet. Of course, if you're in the chair, you can just press your heels towards the floor if you want to. Lifting the toes up off the floor. And then keep your hands on the floor as you start to straighten out your knees. And release it. Roll it on up through the back and through the shoulders. Let's take a step out of the side. Big deep breath in. And exhale it, and we are done. Awesome, awesome job.